We're just going to wait another minute or two. Right now we have 55 people on, just waiting another minute or two, so we'll get started. All right, good afternoon, everybody, and thank you for attending our Zoom call. As many of you probably noticed, we have a few familiar faces on this call. There's also some blasts from the past on this call. Whether you are the current county superintendent, whether you're a Quinton Township Board of Education member, a former Quinton Township School superintendent, a former or present teacher or student, I want to thank you for all that you do and all that you did each and every day and how hard you work for the students here at Quinton Township. And I'd like to turn this Zoom call over to Mr. Joe Cerruti, and he has a special announcement to make. Joe.
Thank you so much, Stu. Happy holidays, everyone. I know that this is a really busy time of the year, so I'll try to keep this brief, but we have a really exciting announcement to make. Every year, the Barbershop Harmony Society, in partnership with the National Association for Music Education, selects one music educator across the country who we believe is making not only the greatest difference for all of the students that they come in contact with, but also their community and their school. And I am beyond excited and pleased to announce to all of you that the 2021 recipient of the Music Educator of the Year on behalf of the Barbershop Harmony Society and the National Association for Music Education is your very own John Wernega. I can honestly tell you all that there is no one that I know of in the over 80-year history of our organization that has been able to do what John has done with a wide range of young singers. Those of us who have been watching John work his magic for so many years tend to take for granted the fact that he's doing this with grade school kids.
Your continual influence in planting those seeds and providing wonderful experiences for young people to continue to grow and learn the benefits and the joy of singing together. We thank you from the bottom of our heart through all the Barbershop community, but especially the Barbershop Harmony Society and our members and fans, and really appreciate the work and dedication you've given in the many, many years. And we look forward to many more wonderful years ahead. Congratulations, John. This will be in the mail to you.
We are so very proud of you as a member of the National Association for Music Education. I got an opportunity to watch some of the videos of you working with the students, and I can tell that you are lighting their souls on fire. You're making a difference so that they feel encouraged, they feel lifted up, and nothing can do that better than music. Congratulations, John. We're proud of you.
To say that you are making a difference would be a huge understatement. You affect not only us immensely, right, to the tune of, you know, having Quin-Tones, all of us pursuing music and art in some way, shape, or form in college, right? But just the leadership that you give to us, not as a musician, as a person, you being the amazing person that you are, you're just having such a huge effect on the lives of all of your students, present and former. This is so deserved, and I'm so, so happy for you, so proud of you, and really blessed to have had you as an educator and for us to have the relationship that we have.
When I first met John, I met John, the musician, when I joined Rittenhouse Sound in 2017. At that time, I just knew him as the baritone who was running sectionals for us, was making learning tracks, was arranging tags and everything for us. It wasn't until he brought the Quin-Tones to rehearsal that, the summer that I first joined that I got to start seeing John the Educator in action. Then a couple months after that, John brought the Wildcat Harmonizers to one of our chapter shows. And it really kind of puts you in your place to get completely shown up by a bunch of elementary school students.
I was fortunate enough to have him come into my life, even as another teacher. But I can't even express, from point one, I gave him credit for being a musical genius, literally. And I watched that so many times, and I still to this day am flabbergasted at how much he taught the all the students at Quinton. Music was such a big part of Quinton school, and that is to John's credit. It's wonderful, John. This is such a well-deserved award. You are a wonderful musician in every regard. And I thank you for letting me be a part of what you do with the kids over the years.
What an honor to receive this award from two of the most prestigious musical organizations in the world. The Barbershop Harmony Society and National Association for Music Education have inspired countless people to pursue a lifetime of creating, teaching, directing, and performing music. People often ask why I chose the path of teaching elementary music instead of high school. To be honest, going into college, I wanted nothing to do with elementary music. Turning the clock forward toward my junior year, I had a methods course with Dr. Lily Levinowitz. She taught us that we should be teaching young children to read music, match pitch, sight sing, and sing harmony. It never dawned on me that this could be done in a general elementary class. One day, she showed us a video about developing children's choirs, and at the end of the video, these children were singing three-part harmony like angels. I was mesmerized. At that point, I traded my dreams of teaching high school choir for the passion to teach young children how to sing four-part harmony. I took on a job at a preschool to eighth grade public school building in a rural area in South Jersey. This was Quinton Township School, which graduated about 30 eighth graders a year. It seemed to be in the middle of nowhere. I never heard of Quinton before, and nobody knew heard of that town. However, I consider this little school to be a musical goldmine, being that I will be teaching the same children for 10 consecutive years. Many years of hard work at Quinton School proved my theory correct. Through the years, I moved further and further away from the norms of elementary music teaching. I had my students performing less and less music written specifically for children and moved more into choral and instrumental repertoire that is performed by adults. Our band and choirs were eventually able to perform music many high schools wouldn't dream of doing, including the spring, the chorale was singing eight-part harmony. I'm hoping that this serves as an inspiration for those who have dreams of making music in an elementary school. Forget about the norms. Create your own path. Make amazing music like never before. And now I'd like to present a little song I wrote thanking BHS and NAfME for this award.
It's such an honor to receive this award for teaching children to sing barbershop chords. Thank you, NAfME and BHS, for opportunities for my students to grow. Sharing music for all generations to know.